The second panel, if I may. Let's see, Thomas Schneider, the Consul General of Switzerland in Los Angeles. Nassimi Aghayev, the Consul General of Azerbaijan in LA, and also the Dean of the Consul Corps here in LA. Mem Chokolo Mbaye, is that good? They get it? Okay. Obviously, I'm the Consul General of Senegal here in Los Angeles. Elizabeth McKay, the delegate from the Quebec Government Office in Los Angeles. And then Guillaume Sorina, the Executive Director of the Alliance Française here in LA as well. And Terry, we'll bring it back to take you to the second panel. Thank you very much.
Nassimi, you are the Consul General of Azerbaijan, a wonderful country which I visited. You're stuck with the Russians and the Persians. You have a rough history. But you do pretty well. Why would Azerbaijan be interested in Francophonie, the world?
Merci beaucoup. C'est un grand plaisir d'être ici ce soir. Et merci à mon ami, le consul honoraire du Sénégal, le ministre de l'Alliance française. Actuellement, j'espérais de parler français aujourd'hui, de rafraîchir un petit peu mon temps de centre de la française. Mais je partage l'opinion que nous avons. Il faut bien sûr parler au groupe plus large que le francophone. So I was actually had to translate everything back to English, but I learned a few days ago that everything will be in English. But I shared the idea that we have to reach out in larger groups. So Azerbaijan is not a French-speaking country. So I'm actually in an old panel because of all my colleagues are from French-speaking countries. As you can imagine, there's a huge admiration for French culture, for French language, and there's a very stormy relationship between Azerbaijan and French culture. And I just not go back too much, just 160 years ago. The famous French writer, Alexandre Dumas, when he was 56 years old, he got a little bit bored in France after a very successful creative life. So he said, let me go to the Caucasus. So he made his trip via Russia to our region, which is Caucasus, where Azerbaijan is located. So he traveled to Azerbaijan, Georgia, and then back to Paris. And in Azerbaijan, I think he had a great time. When he returned, a year later, his book, Voyage au Caucase, or Le Caucase, was published. So we have here, you see here, Alexandre Dumas in a Caucasian outfit, enjoying it tremendously. book, Le Caucase. So that's the actual cover from the book from 1859, when the book was published. So he traveled to Baku, the capital of Azerbaijan, but also some regions, went to the Fire Temple, which is a Zoroastrian temple near Baku. And he said that actually many, this temple is very famous in the world, except in France, because we do not know these areas, especially this kind of terra incognita in France so much. So he tried to change the situation. And I have read his book when I was in Paris trying to learn French some years ago. I found the book and purchased it. I tried to learn French at Alliance Française, but it was too expensive for me in Paris 16 years ago. So I went to another school. So the passage I'd like to read is about hospitality, Alexandre Dumas. So in Azerbaijan. So he wrote, if you knock on any door in Azerbaijan, say that you are a foreigner and have no place to spend the night, the owner of the house will immediately give you his largest room. He and his family will move to the smaller room. Moreover, during the week, 2 weeks, or a month that you stay in his house, he will take care of you and will not let you want for anything. And he also tried to characterize the people of Azerbaijan. In another passage, he said, Azerbaijanis were warriors, and they remain warriors. They love their mountains, high roads, their steppes, and finally, they love their freedom. They are also the ones who make the daggers of the highest caliber, the sheath with rich ornaments, and the rifles inlaid with ivory and silver. With Azerbaijanis, you do not need a signature when you reach an agreement. Their word is enough. So, leur mot est suffisant. That's what he wrote. So actually, that was a pretty, maybe introduction of Azerbaijanis to France. And some 160 or 150 years later, Gérard Depardieu, the famous French actor, came back to Azerbaijan. So he actually followed the route of Alexandre Dumas, and they made a beautiful documentary called Le Retour aux Caucases, The Return to the Caucasus. So it was aired on Arte, this French-German channel, in 2014, and hopefully we'll be able to screen it, maybe in cooperation with Alliance Française, here in Los Angeles as well. So, two episodes, but in general, today in Azerbaijan, since 27 years Azerbaijan has been independent, and France was one of the first countries, actually the second country, to recognize independence. And today French is being taught at over 350 schools, public schools in Azerbaijan, to 50,000 pupils, students in our public schools. There is a French Azerbaijani university accredited by a French university system, a lycée français, a lycée français. So the whole infrastructure is there. So that's why there's a huge, as I said, admiration for the French language and culture.
Who knew Gérard Depardieu had such influence on one country?
Exactly. Really great time to be here.